Okay, so today I'm going to attempt to draw an avatar. Looking at the picture, so it's not off my brain. And it's 8 by 6, width 8, height 6, 16-bit color. Color is white. I might change that, but I don't think I will. I might change it just so you can see what it looks like and then change it back. Okay, so now I'm going to make a new background. Make a new layer, I mean. Make a folder. Put this in the folder. Label it drawing. And then another folder labeled color. And then another folder shadow. Now I might not use these, but these are the ones that I definitely know I probably will need. But I might not use them because I might keep the shadow with the drawing, you know. So that's the case. I might not want to put shadow in a different folder. But color and drawing definitely need to be separated. All right then. Let's get it on. Now let me hit Z for zoom, fill screen, R for rotate, rotate that bisnitch. B for brush, and then scroll. Scroll, baby, scroll. Okay. Now, go to my presets, which I have airbrush tool presets. What are these? Oh, it must be. Oh, okay. It's on brush. Yeah, that's why. Okay. So airbrush and then start. Start your drawing. Okay, I'm gonna start off with the head. Like I said earlier on another drawing, if you want, you can draw it kind of sloppily at first and then trace over it. I don't know what's going on. It's lagging on me. I may need to cut off my computer and start it over to get a real good drawing back on. I don't know why it's doing this. Maybe it's the recorder. Oh, it's annoying. Okay, that's enough. I'm gonna have to start it over. This is taking too long to fit. Okay, there we go. Okay, here we go. Okay. You don't have to search. Okay. So this is getting better, more detailed. I'm drawing the lines that are in the picture, and I'm pretty pleased with it. I might actually trace over this to make it a little more clear, but I might not because I might be content with this. I'm not sure. Not just yet. There it is. Yeah, this looks good to me. Now I'm going to the shadow. This is the drawing. Go to the shadow. Open up a layer. Let's get to the shadowing. Getting the shadow in. And yeah, I hope this video is not too long. I don't think it is, but I haven't colored it yet, so. Okay, so to me this looks detailed. Now I could lighten it up and then go over it again. Go to the drawing, go to the layer. Make it lighter. And then go over it again. Open up another layer. Now this might not do any good, but this is just so you can see how you can clean it up. If you have anything to clean up, but I don't know. Let's see here. Kaboom. I use the opacity to make it lighter, and I use the opacity on the right side of the screen. I'm taking off the shadow because it's a distraction. Okay. Just tracing my own picture. Is that cheating? I don't know. I don't think so. It's my picture. I drew it. It's not like I'm tracing somebody else's picture. Cleaning this up. So, about now. Right about now. To search no further. Yeah. Making this cleaner. Make it look more clean. Less distractions. I hope that's what's happening here. understand why this thing keeps lagging on me. It's making me pissed. I'm trying to get this picture done on time, in a timely manner. See, that looks a little cleaner. You can see everything. Not like that. Scroll down, and then I'm going to crop the picture to where I want it to stop, where the original picture stopped. Yeah, this took a little more time, but I like it. I think it was worth it. Don't you agree? Well, I don't care. I mean, I care to an extent, but not to the most high extent. Obviously, I want to do a good job, set a be draw a good picture, but to each his own, you can't please everybody. Now let's put this shading back on and see how it looks, because I might have to redo that too. No, I don't. It looks good. Be the one, yeah, man. So I guess that's it. I didn't draw the ears, so I gotta go back to the drawing and draw the ears. I might just I don't know, I might not color this. No, I'm gonna color the background and leave the inside like it is. Yeah, I think I'm just gonna do a background coloring and leave this inked, is what I call it. Now I did all this with my airbrush because I'm not coloring. It looks good to me. It's not perfect, but you know what is. What's perfect? I don't know, 'cause perfect is in the eye of the beholder. You might not think it's perfect, but somebody else might. You know how we do. Everybody, somebody's different. Some people are the same. That's just the way it is. So I'm not worried about it. I just want to do my best and leave it to the rest. That's my phone. Turn that off. So this turned out okay. I'm happy with it. This looks good to me. Now let me turn off. Let me see if taking off the other background will actually make it clear or make it look worse. Because sometimes I like to leave it doubled because it looks a little better. What do you think? Why does it look better? What did I do? Trying to make it in. I might leave it double because I like it better that way. That's just my way. It looks better double with the light and the dark. So I'm gonna leave it. And I can do that because it's my picture. Let me see if I want to make this a little darker. Yeah, man. And that's how we roll, yo. Looking good, looking lovely. Okay, now for the background. I told you sometimes I use the background with the sponge, and sometimes I use it with. I think I'm going to do a double layer. I'm going to do the hard round and then go over it with the sponge. But I don't know what color. I like to do a half and a half. But I don't know how I'm going to do that. My favorite color is this maroon. This maroon is my favorite. But I think I'm gonna use the sponge. Yeah. Oh, snap. Snap-a-doodles. Snap a Snapple. Now go to the folder. Go to the folders, color, and create a layer. Pick burgundy. Yeah, I like this. Cause you like me? Yeah, I like you. Cause you like me? Yeah, I like you. Dun, dun. Yeah, I like this. And I'll just clean it up. You can't do this at home, kids. I mean, you can't do this with paper, so you have to be a little more careful. And because of time, I'm going to speed up the process a little bit. Okay. So, this is the background. And something's missing. I think I want to put something else at the bottom. Like I said, sometimes I like to use two colors. So, I'm gonna add another layer, pick yellow. Multiply. There you go, so you can see the lines. That works, actually. And then I'm gonna put yellow at the bottom. No, green. Green, and then just put it at the bottom. And then lighten it. So that's what I want to do. And hopefully it turns out okay. Okay, so I'm cool with it. I don't know, I'm kind of a lazy artist, I think, but I enjoy it. I enjoy the process. I do. And I hope you're learning something from this so you can be a better artist. Better artist than me, maybe. If you're not already, we can all learn from each other. And then, I think I'll change the background so that that won't be the same color. So, that's what I'm gonna do last. Paint bucket. Pick a color to change the background to. No, we're not gonna do it that way. We're gonna make another layer. Okay. And paint bucket. And what color do you want the background to be? That works. And then lighten it to match what you want it to look like. And that works for me. Looks good, baby. I like it. Now let's see if we take off the extra, if it looks better. Now it looks good. Looks good without all that extra stuff. So, that's it, y'all. Now I'm gonna hit Z for zoom and fit to screen, and there's the picture. Looking fly like that. I like it. Anyway, hope you do too. And to each his own if you don't. It's not perfect. It didn't come out exactly the way I wanted it to, but it looks pretty good to me. It looks the way the picture looks. So anyway, talk to you later.